Hey, how about these points to ponder? Why do modern smartphones have several cameras? How much time does the average person spend on their phone? Why do smartphones keep getting bigger? So many questions, and just as many answers. Lots of modern smartphones have multiple rear-facing cameras because it helps to create a 3D model of the scene. When images from several cameras get blended, it produces sharp, high-quality photos. Plus, one camera would not be able to combine all necessary features – zoom, portrait mode, and whatnot. Ooh, is whatnot an actual setting? By the way, the very first camera phone appeared in Japan in 1999. Its front-facing camera had a resolution of 0.11 megapixels. The device could store up to 20 JPEG images and even send them over email. In 2017, 85% of people use their smartphones to take pictures. A bit more than 10% use digital cameras, and just 5% their tablets. Smartphones equipped with high-resolution cameras have caused a photography boom. During 2013, people all over the world took 660 billion digital photos. 4 years later, this number was already 1,200 billion pics. You can use your smartphone camera to scan and digitize old negatives. Choose the negative effect option in the camera app and take a photo of the film. The quality might not be that great, but you have your childhood pics now. Nomophobia is a fear of being left without your smartphone. It's a short form of no mobile phone phobia. Lots of people nowadays also have ring anxiety. They hear or feel their phones ringing when they aren't. Oh boy. There are smartphone apps that allow you to lock, unlock, and even start your car with the help of your gadget. Throwing cell phones is a national sport in Finland. Competitions are held every year. Participants aren't allowed to bring their own phones and have to throw donated devices. What's the fun of that? Almost 3.5 billion people own a smartphone these days. In other words, nearly every second person you meet in the street will have their own device. The old Nokia text ringtone is Morse code for the letters SMS. Ooh, we should have a bright side ringtone. What do you think? Leave your ideas in the comments. Depending on age, the average smartphone user unlocks their device up to 80 times a day. The record holder is Generation Z, people born between the 1990s and the early 2010s. You can turn your smartphone into a nightlight if the device has an LED flash. Get a transparent plastic bottle and fill it with water. Switch on your phone's flashlight, place the gadget face up, and put the bottle over it. The light from the flash will get diffused, and the makeshift lamp will illuminate your room. After doing some online shopping, in a web browser or a mobile app, 42% of smartphone users open another shopping app or a communication app. I think it means they either continue their shopping spree or go tell their friends about their purchases. Smartphones are getting bigger because that's what people need. Lots of users prefer their phones to laptops or tablets since they're easier to handle. And big screens make smartphones very convenient whenever you want to watch a video, browse the internet, or play a game. Most smartphone users spend up to 3 hours per day on their phone. It's 1 hour more than it used to be in 2012. And since the average global lifespan is 72 years, throughout your life, you'll use your smartphone for 6 years and 8 months. It's twice more than you'll spend on eating and drinking. Android Google Maps have a one-icon widget that will always direct you to the address you've chosen, for example, your home. You can make a home screen shortcut that will take you to the needed destination from any other place. Just tap it. You'll probably be using a modular smartphone in the nearest future. It'll be a device with components you'll be able to upgrade independently. The basic part will be the main board to which you'll attach additional modules, such as a powerful camera or battery. This will make the repair cost of such phones way lower. The first smartphone was named Simon. It had a touchscreen, keyboard, games and an address book, a calendar, a world clock, and calculator apps. You could use it to send emails and faxes. The price of the device was more than $1,000. Simon says, "Buy me, financing available." Modern-day smartphones are packed with cutting-edge technologies and functions. And still, the most common use of these powerful devices is checking the time. Bluetooth was named after a Nordic king, Harald Bluetooth Blattend. The man was famous for his persuasion skills. He also had a blue tooth. I wonder what would have happened if he had had bad body odor instead. And yes, this smartphone is stinky compatible. Well, that sure doesn't have the same je ne sais quoi. Android phones have a menu option called App Cloner, which can create several copies of the same app. It allows you to simultaneously run multiple accounts from the same device. You can also keep different versions of one application. Smartphones do not slow down with time, even though it may seem so. With rapidly changing technologies, developers add tons of new features to their apps. These updates draw more resources from your phone. That's why your favorite apps start working more slowly on your gadget. Plus, older phones usually have their memory cramped, which doesn't help the situation. Your smartphone can see infrared. If you direct a beam of such light, for example, from your TV remote control at your phone's camera, you'll see a purple spot on the screen. Most digital cameras have sensors that detect light frequencies invisible to the human eye. The number of mobile apps people download increases every year, from 178 billion in 2017 to 204 billion 2 years later. Among the most popular, there are YouTube, Facebook, Google Maps, Gmail, and WhatsApp. Smartphones can read not only QR codes, but traditional barcodes too. If you download a special barcode reading app, you'll be able to compare prices or make inventories with the help of your mobile device. People all over the world are currently using more than 10 billion mobile devices. That's more than the entire Earth's population. If you have an Android smartphone, you can program your alarm to get louder and louder. Find three vertical dots at the main alarm page and choose the option Gradually Increase Volume. But why would you want to? The average smartphone user has 60 to 90 apps on their device. Only half of them are used regularly. Some Android smartphones can open apps side by side or even one above the other. Tap the Overview button. It's the square icon at the bottom of the screen on the left. There, you need to choose one of the recently used apps. Drag the one you need to the left or the top of the screen. Then choose the other app you want to open. And while we're at it, you can easily and quickly switch between the two apps you've been opening most often recently. All you need to do is double-tap the Overview button. 1 ton of cell phone waste contains dozens of times more gold than 1 ton of gold ore. I think we'll end on that golden nugget.